What's the matter? Cat got your tongue all of a sudden?
Well, you look like a bum. You smell like a bum, too. Jesus. That's one ugly scar you got. Hey, fellas. I don't think this bum knows where he is. And you must not know who I am, neither. Wanna find out? Huh?
You talk too much, whoever you are.
Now wait just a minute. What is that? Is that your dog? Come here, Pooch. Come here.
Oh, dear.
Hey! Here he comes now, Gilly.
Get away from my dog.
Is that your wife? Roy, I seen you with some long in the tooth ladies, but this one here takes a cake.
You started this.
I'm gonna finish it, too.
Marianne, you better not be serving that man.
I am too. And you shut your mouth. I don't want him hearing none of this.
Did you see what he did to Gilly?
Look at my dress. The whole town practically saw. Good. Gilly deserves some egg on his face the way he treats people.
You watch your mouth.
No. I'll say what I want and I'll serve who I want. That's it for us to run this hotel, not just you.
He could be a criminal. So have some sense.
Oh, Alan, shut up. You let me worry about this. I think he's handsome. And I like his dog. And I want to know more about them both. I'm not scared, and you're not gonna ruin this for me.
You foolish little girl. One day you'll realize there's no sense in being difficult. You make the best of what you can. Now, Gilly takes care of me. So every time you put him down, you want to remember that he's why I'm always in nice dresses and jewelry, and you're still looking like a little old farm girl. There's a reason we have it better than most people in this town. So wise up. Maybe then you'll find someone to take care of you too, but it's not gonna be that man upstairs, because he is a rapscallion! And we don't serve rapscallions.
Well, maybe I'd like rapscallions. Now go tend to that nincompoop fiancé of yours and leave me be. Show him how he ruined your dress. See if he buys you a new one then. Maybe he can fix that black tooth of yours while he's at it.
That's a sweet doggy. She doing her tricks?
She bites.
All right. Down to business, I guess. I am Clyde Martin. I am the marshal here in Denton.
You got a badge?
Damn pen broke. Satisfied? You busted up my deputy pretty good.
I had no idea he was your deputy. I was just trying to defend myself.
I know you were. Nobody dare tell me that because it's my son. And I know how he is. But defending or not, he's still my son and he's my deputy too. So all this looks kind of lousy for me. But I can't have people thinking this kind of business goes on around here. First fight breaks out, then another. And all of a sudden all hell breaks loose and everybody's got something to say. This town's falling on some hard times. The last thing I need is a stranger starting trouble.
Yeah, but I'm not going to cause any troubles. No. We're just passing through.
Now, is that your horse over there at Bill's outfit? That's a McClellan saddle. And would I be right to suspect
that that is a Springfield trapdoor rifle that you got tied up there to? I could throw you in jail right now. You want that? I don't think so. Only one reason I don't. That's on two items on your horse. Because what they tell me is that you're just not another vagabond or a criminal that I should be locking away. It tells me that you're army. But what it does not tell me is why the hell are you all the way out here? Now, last I heard, the cavalry was still busy killing Injuns in Kansas and Oklahoma. And we are a long way from Kansas, soldier. You mind filling me in?
We're leaving.
What happened?
You went after that man, didn't you? I told you not to. I made it perfectly clear that you were not to aggravate the situation, but you did, didn't you?
All of you did.
We couldn't let him get away with what he did. It would have made us look weak.
Wait! Stop! Stop!
Don't think that I'll let him go because I'm weak.
No.
Look at this. That's not done by an angry drunk or a minor that has a sense of entitlement. This was done by a military man. A man trained to kill by one of the most ruthless divisions our country has ever seen. Something you would know nothing about. And you think just because you got a prick and a pistol, you can kill somebody with blood or love and death.
I can't do this, Marshal. I'm sorry. I just can't.
Okay.
It's a lot to take. I didn't know it would be like this.
All right, now Tubby.
Stop calling me Tubby! I don't want to be called that anymore. I'm not even that fat. You all act like all I do is sit around eating all day. I don't. I work. And I ain't less than y'all. This is just the way God made me. And I accept that. But if I'm gonna die here today, I am not gonna be called Tubby. I mean it.
Now look, I will call you whatever you want if we just get through this, but please.
Lawrence, my name is Lawrence.
All right, Lawrence, Larry, please, for the love of God, get away from the goddamn window.
So, are you a big movie fan? Well, I've got some interesting movie facts for you. Did you know that over 90% of American movies made before 1929 are lost? No copies are known to exist. Now that's a big shame. Okay, now think about the movie The Godfather. It's all about the mafia, no? Well, the word mafia is never mentioned in the film because the actual mafia demanded it. This next one is really interesting. Did you know that Pulp Fiction, Forrest Gump, The Shawshank Redemption, and the re-release of Jurassic Park were all in theaters at the same time in October of 1994? Now, that would have been a hard choice of what to watch, or you would have had a busy month at the cinema. The first one I would have seen was Pulp Fiction. What about you? Which one of these was or still is your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. See you next time.